Now, dear children, we are going to do some numerical problems. First, related to combination of errors. So, see that question. I am just reading. In an experiment, two capacitors of capacities measured are C1 is equal to 1.3 plus minus 0.1 microfarad. And C2 is equal to 2.4 plus minus 0.2 microfarad. Calculate the total capacity in parallel with the percentage error. Here is your question. Two values diya hua hai. Here we have to remember the formula when the capacitors are in parallel. This formula we have to remember here, C1 plus C2. So I can say here the error in parallel I can say CP is equal to C1 plus C2, that is equal to 1.3 plus 2.4, that is equal to 3.7, and the error here is delta of CP, that is I can say plus minus delta of C1 plus delta of C2, that is 0.1 and 0.2. So I can write here 0.1 plus 0.2, so that is, you may write edit, so you get it here plus minus 0.3 here. Now, so what is the percentage error? We can find out here. The percentage error would be plus minus 0.3 divided by 3.7. It is the error divided by 3.7 into 100. Into 100%. Solve it. So you will get it near about 8.1%. So hence I can say CP would be, that is 3.7 plus minus 0.3, that is the error. This symbol mu, it is called micro. Micro means 10 raised to the power minus 6. So dear children, you can write here 3.7 microfarad. Plus minus, what is the error here? 8.1%. So this is the result. Now, we take one more numerical here. Now listen, first numerical, what is the problem? The length of the two cylinders are measured to be L1 is equal to 5.62 plus minus 0.01 centimeter, and L2 is measured, that is 4.34 plus minus 0.02 centimeter. Calculate the difference in length with error limits. Listen again. Calculate difference in length with the error limits. It is our problem. Now, the length diya hua hai, L1 5.62 plus minus this one, and L2 this one. So L dash comes out to be L1 minus L2, that is 5.62 minus 4.34. So you will get it here 1.28 centimeter. This and this. Then what is the error here? Delta of L dash, that is this and this. So plus minus delta of L1 plus delta of L2. That would be plus minus 0.01 plus 0.02. Plus minus 0.03 here. So what is the percentage error would be? The percentage error would be plus minus 0.03 divided by 1.28 into 100 here. So this is the solve it. When you solve it, you will get it near about plus minus 2.34%. This is the percentage error. So hence, difference in length is equal to 1.28 plus minus 0.03 centimeter. Or I can write 1.28 plus minus error, that is 2.34%. This is the result. This. So this is the way we can easily solve the problems. Now, we see the NCERT problem, question number 10. State the number of significant figures in the following. A 0.007 meter square, B 2.64 into 10 to the power 24 kg, C. This question is at NCERT page number 35. C, that is 0.2370 gram per centimeter cube. D, 6.320 joule. E, 6.032 newton per meter square. And F, 0.0006032. It asks us what is the significant figure of this. Here you say first 0.007. The underlined zeros are not a significant figure. So here I can write significant figure is 1. Here 2.64. This is meaningless. So here the number of significant figure is 3. Here the number of significant figure after the decimal point 4. Here the number of significant figure is 4. Here also the number of significant figure is 4. Here also the number of significant figure is 4. So this is the way. If you know the rules how to find out the significant figure, then you can solve it. Now, see the NCERT test book page number 36. And question number 13, I am just reading. A physical quantity P is related to four observables A, B, C and D as follows. P is equal to A cube B square divided by under root of C, D. This is the percentage error of measurement A, B, C and D are 1%, 3%, 4% and 2% respectively. What is the percentage error in the quantity P? This is our problem. What is asking? What is the percentage error in the quantity? So maximum fractional error in P is given by, I can write here, delta P by P is equal to A to the power cube. The power may be taken here, delta A by A plus 2 delta B by B plus root C 1 by 2 delta C by C, and here is power 1 delta D by D. All are given. One percent, I can write here 3 into 1 by 100 plus 2 into 3 by 100. Similarly, 1 by 2, 4 by 100, plus delta D by D, that is 2 by 100. तो ये 6 और 3 9 और 4 13, तो ये क्या है, 6 और 3 9 और 2 11 और 2 13, तो हियर वी आर गेटिंग 13 by 100, दैट इज इक्वल टू 0.13. तो परसेंटेज एरर यू कैन फाइंड आउट, पी इज इक्वल टू डेल्टा पी बाय पी इनटू 100. डेल्टा पी बाय पी जस्ट यू कैलकुलेटेड राइट नाउ 0.13 × 100, दैट इज इक्वल टू 13%. दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम, यू कैन सॉल्व इट, आल्सो एन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉब्लम. नाउ Now we take some more question here of our NCERT textbook page number 37. Say question number 23 and 24 do karenge hum abhi. The sun is a hot plasma with its inner core at a temperature exceeding 10^7 Kelvin and its outer surface at a temperature of about 6000 Kelvin. At such high temperature, no substance remain in a solid or liquid phase. In what range do you expect the mass density of the sun to be? In the range of densities of the solids, liquid or gases, check if your guess is correct from the following data: mass of the sun, diava quote, that is 2 × 10^30 kg. रेडियस ऑफ द सन दिया हुआ है आपको 7 × 10^8 मीटर. तो हियर मास इज गिवन, रेडियस इज गिवन, डेंसिटी वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट. डेंसिटी इज इक्वल टू होता है मास अपॉन वॉल्यूम, पुट मास अपॉन वॉल्यूम, दैट इज 4/3 πr³. तो ये 3m/4πr³, पुट द वैल्यूज, 3 × मास, दैट इज 2 × 10^30 4 × 22/7 × r³, 7 × 10^8 का क्यूब. दिस इज, पुट दिस वैल्यूज एंड सॉल्व, तो यू विल गेट इट अराउंड 1.39 × 10^3 किलोग्राम पर मीटर क्यूब. दिस इज द डेंसिटी हियर, दिस इज द ऑर्डर ऑफ डेंसिटी ऑफ सॉलिड्स एंड लिक्विड, इट इज नॉट द ऑर्डर ऑफ गैस. सो आई कैन से द हाई डेंसिटी ऑफ सन इज ड्यू टू इनवर्ड ग्रेविटेशनल अट्रैक्शन ऑन आउटर लेयर्स ड्यू टू द इनर लेयर्स ऑफ द सन. So this is the simple numerical, we can solve it. Now we take one more question here. Next question number 24 of the same page. When the planet Jupiter is at a distance of 824.7 million kilometers from the Earth. Millions kilometer from the earth, its angular diameter is measured to be 35.72 of the arc. It is given. Calculate the diameter of the Jupiter. Our problem is to find out the diameter of the Jupiter. Here, dear children, here it is given, the distance r is equal to 824.7 million, means 10^6 kilometer. The angular arc is given 35.72, that is in, I can convert into radian, 35.72 divided by 60 into 60 into pi by 180 radian. This is converted unit in radian. This one is converted into radian. So diameter, our formula here is L is equal to R theta. R here is 824 into 10 raised to power 6 into 35.72 into pi divided by 60 into 60 into 180. Solve it. So we can easily calculate 1.42 into 10 raised to power 5 kilometer. Simplest way. This formula is angle बराबर arc upon radius. So you can solve this problem like this. Okay? Now we'll do some more numericals based on usage of dimensional analysis. Now, question based on usage of dimensional analysis. So write down first question. If the unit of force is kilonewton and that of time is in millisecond and that of power is in kilowatt, then what would be the unit of mass and length? Mass and length. This is our problem. So just read the question and then we are going to solve here. How to solve? Write down first what is the dimensional formula for the force. The dimensional formula for the force is m1 l1 t minus 2. That is equal to 1 kilonewton. 1 kilonewton. 1 kilonewton means 1000 newton. Here it is, you can write 1000 newton. Time it is given 1 millisecond. Millisecond means 10 raised to power minus 3 second. And unit of power, dimensional formula for the power, that is equal to m1 l2 t minus 3, that is 1 kilowatt, so 1000 watt here. These are the things given to us. First find out f upon t, divide these two. So you are getting here m1 l1 t minus 3, f by t करिए, 1000 divided by 10 raised to power minus 3, 1000 divided by 10 raised to power minus 3, that is 10 raised to power 6, f by t is here. Then divide this equation by this equation, f by t, this by this. So you can see here m1 l2 t minus 3 divided by m1 l1 t minus 3, that is equal to 1000 divided by 10 raised to power 6, that is 10 raised to power 3. So you can say here this is cancelled, L comes out to be 10 raised to power minus 3. This is, so value of L here, put the value of L and T in our equation number first, that is F is equal to m1 l1 t minus 2 is equal to 1000 newton. Put there m l, l is 10 raised to power minus 3, एम वन एल टी माइनस टू, टी इज 10^-3 की पावर माइनस टू, दिस इज इक्वल टू 1000 10^3. यू कैन सॉल्व एंड कैलकुलेट इट, एम इज इक्वल टू 1 kg, दिस इज ऑल थिंग विल कैंसिल आउट, दिस इज -3 -2 तो +6 मल्टीप्लाइड इट 6 - 3 - 3 3 से 3 कैंसिल ऑनली रिमेन्स विल बी एम इज इक्वल टू 1 kg. तो दिस इज द वे टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम्स. इज इट क्लियर? राइट डाउन. नाउ चेक द एक्यूरेसी ऑफ द फॉर्मूला दैट इज आवर डायमेंशनल एनालिसिस यूजेस. We are going to see here two formulas. Check the accuracy of formula lambda is equal to h by mv and here e is equal to mc square. Lambda is the wavelength, h is the Planck constant, m is the mass, v is the velocity. In the left hand side, this is lambda, this is distance. Dimensional formula for the distance is L. On the right hand side, here it is a Planck constant. The dimensional formula for Planck constant is m1 l2 t minus 1. Here is mass and here is velocity lt minus 1. Here it is cancelled. Here is L. This is also cancelled. Right hand side and left hand side both are same. So we can say this is our correct formula. Here is the Einstein formula. E is the energy, mass and velocity. So in the LHS, first write down the dimensional formula for energy. What is the dimensional formula for the energy? M1 L2 T minus 2. M1 L2 T minus 2. LHS. And on RHS, mass and velocity lt minus 1 ki power 2 m l2 t minus 2. This is the result. So you can see left hand side and right hand side both are equal. Now we take two more numericals based on third uses of dimensional analysis to derive the formula using dimensional analysis. So listen that first question. The wavelength lambda of a metal waves depends upon Planck constant h, mass and velocity of the particle. Mass and velocity of a particle. Wavelength depend on three factors. Using the method of dimension, derive the formula. This is our problem. So now, what we have to do? So dear children, lambda is proportional to h की power a, dimension इसका b मान लीजिए, इसका c मान लीजिए. So constant of proportionality k, h की power a, m, b, v, c like this. Write the dimension on both the side. Then what will you get? Here it is L only. M0, L1, T0. Here is the Planck constant. M1, L2, T minus 1. M1, L2, T minus 1 ki power A. M ki power B. And L, T minus 1 ki power C. Compare the power on both the side. M की पावर a प्लस b, L की पावर 2a प्लस c, T की पावर माइनस a माइनस c, M0, L1, T0. बेस सेम है, पावर को जोड़ लीजिए. व्हाट वी आर गेटिंग हियर, a प्लस b इज इक्वल टू 0, 2a प्लस c इज इक्वल टू 1, एंड माइनस ए माइनस सी इज इक्वल टू जीरो. तो सॉल्व इट. माइनस ए इज इक्वल टू सी, तो सी की जगह माइनस ए रख दीजिए इसमें. तो टू ए माइनस ए इज इक्वल टू वन, तो ए इज इक्वल टू वन आ गया. ए इज इक्वल टू वन यहां रखेंगे तो बी इज इक्वल टू आ गया माइनस वन. तो सी इज इक्वल टू आ गया माइनस वन, यहां पर रखिए. ए इज इक्वल टू वन, बी इज इक्वल टू माइनस वन एंड सी इज इक्वल टू ऑल्सो माइनस वन. पुट दीज वैल्यूज हियर. तो लैम्डा कम्स आउट टू बी एच की पावर ए वन, एम की पावर बी वन माइनस वन एंड वी की पावर माइनस वन. तो लैम्डा इज इक्वल टू के इंटू एच बाई एम बी. दिस इज द फॉर्मूला. इट्स अ वेरी सिंपल मेथड. वी कैन इजीली फाइंड आउट और डिराइव द फॉर्मूला. वी टेक वन मोर क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन दिस. यस, एक्सपेरिमेंट शोज दैट द फ्रीक्वेंसी एन ऑफ अ ट्यूनिंग फॉर्क डिपेंड्स अपॉन ऑन द लेंथ ऑफ द प्रॉन्ग एल, डेंसिटी डी एंड यंग्स मॉडुलस ऑफ द मटेरियल वाई. It depends on three factors. Then using the dimensional analysis, derive the formula for the frequency of a tuning fork. N depends on three factors, L ki power A, D ki power B and Y ki power C. So the constant of proportionality here is K, L ki power A, D ki power B and Y ki power C. This one. Now, write the dimension on both the side. Write the dimension on both the side and solve the problems. Write the dimension on both the side and solve the problems. You will get it here. It's up to you for your assignment work and solve it. You will get it like put the value of dimensional formula of L, density and Young's modulus and compare it. So what you are observing here? Now, so dear children, here is the length, density, and Young's modulus. So write down the dimensional formula on both the side and we can, here it is the frequency t minus 1, length L ki power A, density mass upon volume m by L cube, m L minus 3 ki power B. Now, what is the dimensional formula for Young's modulus? See that. M1 L minus 1 T minus 2. M1 L minus 1 T minus 2. Key power C. Now, so here I can write m ki power b plus c, l ki power a minus 3b minus c and t ki power minus 2c. Here m0, l0, t minus 1. compare these two equations. B plus C is equal to 0. A minus 3B minus 3 C is equal to 0. Minus 2C is equal to minus 1. C is equal to 1 by 2 again. Now, put here. B is equal to minus 1 by 2. C is equal to 1 by 2 here. B is equal to minus 1 by 2. And then L. Put here. So what you are getting? A is equal to 3B plus C. 3B is B is equal to minus 1 by 2. And plus C is equal to 1 by 2. So minus 3 by 2 and plus 1 by 2. Minus 1 again. Put all these values over there. This is minus 1.5 plus 0.5. So this is minus 1. Okay, right. What we are getting here? N comes out to be K L ki power minus 1 B ki power B minus 1 by 2 and Y ki power C 1 by 2. So we are getting here K by L under root of Y by D. This is the result. Okay? So this is the way to solve the problems. It totally depends on you that if you know the dimensional formula, then we can easily solve the problems. So this is all about this numerical side. Do more numericals, practice again and again, write in notes, and learn the things accurately. Okay?